300 students passed in both the subjects. Find the total number of students who appeared in the examination if they took examination in only two subjects. Okay, that is perfectly all right. We will remember these numbers first. 50, 70, 10. Okay. 300 in both the subjects. Okay. Let's go to Venn diagram. These kind of problems where percentages are given without figures, better to use Venn diagram only to avoid the complications. Okay. Right. So here in the Venn diagram, y is the, not y, this is 300, right? Y is 300. 300 is the students who passed in both the examinations. So this is 300. Okay. So this one will be 0.5x minus 300. Why 0.5x minus 300? Because, okay, this way that is fine. Why like that? Why? Because this is only maths, right? 50% students actually passed in mathematics. That is, this is the entire set, and this is the students who passed only maths. The students who passed only sciences, intersection part you need to subtract. Okay. So 0.7x minus 300. What about failed students? Right. Failed students are here. This is the number of failed students, 0.1x. Okay. I am not going to follow this. Am I going to follow this? No, I am making use of Venn diagram alone. So let me remove the parts which I don't need. Okay. What I am going to follow here? Okay, I will write it somewhere else. Right, here I will write n of m union s. What is being asked is n of u, total number of students, right? Why n of u is total number of students? This is maths only. This is maths and science, and this is the students. This is the math students who passed maths only. This is the students who passed science only. This is the students who passed both the subjects. Okay, and this one is the failed students. So that is what being asked, right? The number who appeared is nothing but n of u. Okay, so this plus this plus this is n of u, right? N of m union s, or otherwise I can write n of f. N of f is n of failed plus n of m union s. It should be small then. Okay, is nothing but the number of students appeared in the examination, because there are only two exams were being conducted, right? Okay, so n of f is, you know, 0.1x. what else, you know? N of m union s, you can find it out from the Venn diagram itself, right? 1.2x. I am directly writing. Okay, 1.2x minus 300, right? Yes, minus 300. Okay, 2 times 300 will come. This 300 will cancel out. So 1.2x minus 300. So nothing but 1.3x minus 300. What is n of u? N of u is nothing but x. That is what is required, right? So this is equal to x. Figure it out here. 1.3x minus x is 0.3x. So 0.3x equal to 300. If 0.3x is 300, x is what? 1000. Okay. 3x is 3000 multiplying with 10, x is 1000. Okay, you can place the x value and you can cross check also. You will get the 1000 only here. Okay, this is what is being asked, 1000. So answer we can directly write it here. Where is the problem? Sixth problem. Yeah, 1000. Okay. Right, Venn diagram actually helped us to solve this problem quite quickly. A and B are two sets such that n of A minus B is this, n of B minus A is this, n of A intersection B is this. Illustrate the information by means of Venn diagram. Given that n of A equal to n of B, calculate the value of X. Again, we need to go to the Venn diagram only, right? Not a difficult problem, but without Venn diagram, it's quite difficult. Okay, A intersection B is X, so we need not to use these numbers anymore. These letters have to be changed to A and B initially. Right, this is X. Okay, this is X. What else is given? N of A minus B, N of B minus A, 32 plus X, 5X. Okay. Okay, I can proceed it from here. N of A minus B is A minus B is 32 plus X. Is it what is given? Yes, 32 plus X. N of B minus A is 5X. B minus A is 5X. Okay. N of B minus A equal to 5X. Okay, now one more information is given. N of A equal to, this is also important, N of B. Right. Fair enough. Okay, we will, what we have to do, we have to figure out this, right? These numbers are not quite correct. Okay, this number also not correct, only X we know. Okay, let's remove other numbers to avoid the confusion, unnecessary confusion, because X is there, X is there. Okay, what is N of A minus B? That we need to figure out first. N of A minus B and N of B minus A. Yeah. So only hockey, only cricket. Okay, this is A minus B. Okay, fair enough. X 5X. Okay, very simple problem actually. That is 32 plus X, N of A minus B. Okay. This is N of B minus A is 5X. Yeah, here we wrote, right? 5X. Okay. So n of a equal to n of b. Oh, from there we need to figure it out, right? Right. So we will equate first. What is n of a? That we will write it here. N of a is 32x plus x, 32 plus 2x. Okay. What is n of b then? 5x plus x. 5x plus x, nothing but 6x. Right. So n of a equal to n of b. So we will equate both. Okay. We will equate. Yes, we will equate both. 32 plus 2x equal to 6x. In other words, 4x equal to 32. 6x minus 2x. Directly I am writing 4x equal to 32. Or x equal to 32 by 4, nothing but 8. So what is being asked here? Is it x? Calculate the value of x. How much? 8. Right. Out of 500 car owners investigated, 400 owned a car A, 200 owned car B, 50 owned both A and B. Is this data correct? Oh. 500 car owners investigated, 400 owned car A, 200 owned car B, 50 owned both A and B. Okay. So, add these two up. 600 minus 50. Is 550 more than 500, so the data is incorrect. It's not correct. Okay, is it a lot last problem? No, there also. Oh, so much thing to do now. How to then? I hope in one video we may not able to cover if we are going to solve all the problems. Let's see. In a colony, 275 families by Tamil newspaper. 150 families by English newspaper, 45 families by Hindi newspaper, 125 families by Tamil and English newspaper, 17 families by English and Hindi newspapers, 5 families by Tamil and Hindi newspapers, and 3 families by all the newspapers. If each family buy at least one of these newspapers, and then find, okay, what we need to find, that we will figure it out later. Okay, let's draw the Venn diagram here itself. Why here? Why not somewhere else? We cannot put numbers inside if you draw Venn diagram here, but it would be easier to draw the Venn diagram here. Why? Because every time we need to, oh, this much only we can copy. Every time we need to go there to find the data. Data is already here. Okay. Right. Rectangle. Yes, reduce the size, fair enough. This part little bit. Okay, this is fair enough. Okay, we will put Tamil newspaper first. Okay, that is T for Tamil. By English newspaper, and then English, E for English, and H for Hindi. This is H, right? Okay. Now 275 families by Tamil newspaper, no problem. 150 families by so the numbers we can write here perhaps. What are those numbers? Whatever it may be, n of t, n of like that, n of t equal to 250. 275. Okay, and what else? N of E equal to how much? 125, 150, 150, and N of Hindi H equal to how much? N of H equal to 45. Okay. What else is given? That also we need to write. Okay, what else is given? N of ₹125 families by Tamil and English newspapers. T intersection D. And you need to write everything. I can directly use it in when the Venn diagram. Okay, space is not sufficient, right? To write the workout part. Yeah, where is my? I'm not getting it anymore. Okay, no problem. I'm going to use this number. What is this number? Tell me the number. 125 families by Tamil and English. 125. Tamil and English is this. Okay. 125. Both Tamil and English. Right. And what else? Tamil and English. 17 families by English and Hindi. This is English and Hindi common. 17, right? 17 English and Hindi. Okay. What else? 5 families by Tamil and Hindi. Tamil and Hindi also 5 families. With that you need to keep it here, Tamil and Hindi, right? And 3 families by all the 3 newspaper. Okay, that is 3 by all the newspaper. This is the intersection, right? For all the 3. Okay, fair enough. Then what we need to find, we will see. If each family buy at least one of these newspapers, then find each family finds gets. If each family buy at least one of these newspapers, total families is 275. Enough you if you think. Okay, and this is 0 then. Okay, so 275 families. I am putting it directly here. N of U is how much? Is 275. Yes, 275 total families, right. So this part is 0, that you need to remember. Otherwise I can put 0 directly there. Number of families by only one newspaper. That we are going to figure it out now. No problem. 275 minus 125 is how much? 75 minus 25, 50. 250 minus 100 is 150. 150 minus 150 minus 5, 145. 145 minus 3, 142. So 142 is this. Who read only Tamil paper? Add them up, you should get 275. 5 plus 3, 8 plus 140 to 150 प्लस 125 275, फेयर इनफ। दिस इज इंग्लिश राइट, 150, सो 150 माइनस 125 इज 25, 25 माइनस 25 so this 5 has to come here. Now add them up, 130 plus 20, 150, fair enough. What about Hindi? Let's see Hindi also. Hindi is 45, this is 20 plus 5, 25, 45 minus 25 is 20, isn't it? Yes, 20. So this 20 has to come here. Okay, now only Tamil is 142, only this is 5, only this is 20. Okay, each family buy at least one of these newspapers, then find number of families buy only one newspaper. ₹142 plus 5, ₹147 plus 20, how much? ₹142 plus 5, ₹147 plus 20, ₹167. Okay, ₹142 plus 25, ₹167. So ₹167. Okay, fair enough. Control V, ₹167 are the people who buy only one newspaper. Okay, total is 275. No, only 275 families buy this 150. This is fine. If enough is not 275, sorry, my mistake. This you don't know, right now you don't know, so question mark is good enough. So 167 is the answer for the first question. Okay, will it come from this page to this page? Okay, okay, fair enough. Then why is it not coming? Okay, 167 is this number of families buy at least two newspapers, at least two, this plus this. Okay, that means these people are buying all the three newspapers, but they are buying two newspapers as well, right? At least two, he asked only two, then you should exclude 3. If it is at least 3, 2, you should include the ones who are buying all the three. Okay, so this is 17 plus 3, 20. 20 plus 130, 150. So 150 is the answer. Okay. Total number of families in the colony. Total number of families in the colony. Everything we need to add them up. This is zero, right? From the information given, this is zero. So 150 is this. This is 20. That is 170. 170 plus 142. 2, 1, 3. Oh, let's try to do everything in the air. We will put the numbers here and add. What's the issue? What is the number? 142 plus 5 is 140. Yeah, 142. Keep it 142 plus 17 3 20. Oh, this is 150 plus 25. The remaining is 25 only, right? 20 here, 5 here. Okay, nothing but 292 is this. 92. Oh, plus 25. Isn't it correct? Yes, 292 plus 25. This is 7. Okay, 7 is the last digit. 9 plus 2 11, 11 plus 1 is 12. So 327 is the answer. Okay, if there is any calculation mistake, you can correct it, no problem. But this is the methodology in which you need to solve this problem. Okay, anyway, using Venn diagram, it was very simple. Without Venn diagram, it would be complex. Okay, that is the reason why we use Venn diagram. Okay, this part anyway, he gave it as zero. Okay, fair enough. Let's go to the other problem. A survey of 1000 farmers found that 600 group paddy, 350 group ragi, 280 group corn, 120 grew, if each farmer grew at least one of the above three, then find the number of farmers who grew all the three. See, similar problem, that's why I'm not going to solve it once again. Okay, I'm leaving it for you. In the Edison diagram, n of u is 125. Y is, this problem is quite interesting, right? Okay, this we will solve it here. Y is 2 times x, then y to write y. We will write x 2x only. Okay. And what else is given? Y is 2x, z is more 10 more than x. Instead of z, I can write 10 plus x because it is 10 more than x. Okay, right, z is 10 more than x. Then find the values of x, y, z. Pretty simple problem, I guess. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 17, 30 plus 10, this 10 is there, right? 30 plus 10 is 40. 40 plus 5, 45. So here place is sufficient. 45 plus x plus, not to write everything I guess, but let's see, x plus 2x plus x equal to how much? 125. okay, that is 2 plus 2, 4x is 125 minus 4x is 125 minus 45. 125 minus 45, 125 minus 5, 120, 120 minus 40, 80. 80. If 4x is 80, x is how much? 20. So once you know the x, 2x is 40, 10 plus x is 30. Okay. You want to see, check the result? Let's check the result by putting the numbers. Okay, 20 here, then 40 here, then 30, 10 plus 20 is 30 here. Let's add them up. Let's add every number up. 20 plus 40, 60, 60 plus 30, 90. Okay, this part is 90 up to here. This is 20 plus 10, 30. 90 plus 30, 120. Plus 5, 125. Okay, fair enough. That is correct. And each student in a class of 35 plays at least one game among chess, carom, table tennis. 22 play chess, 21 play carom, 15 play table tennis, 10 play chess and table tennis, 8 play carom and table tennis, 6 play all the three games. Find the number of students who play chess and carom but not table tennis. Oh, similar problem. Only chess, only carom. Chess and carom but not table tennis. See here. Where it went? Downward direction. Okay. We need to use Venn diagram for that problem. We did not get the place. We are not getting place. Somewhere we need to compromise where this label is quite fair enough. You think that there is, this label is not here. Okay, that would be better, I guess. Now remove this. Okay. This is fair enough, right? Right. We'll put it back. Okay. Now we need to name, yes, chess is C for chess, C for chess. Okay, then caroms, CA. Okay, CA for caroms. And what else is there? Table tennis, T is fine, fair enough. T is fine, right? Okay, now let's see the numbers. Number game, everything is a number game here. Each student in a class of 35, so union is 35, at least one among the chess, carom, table tennis. Okay, so this is 0, they play one among these three, that means this is 0. 22 play chess, okay. 21 play carom, that's fair enough. 15 play table tennis. Okay, let's now fill up the things, okay. First, what you need to fill up? Those who play all the games. 6 play all the 3 games, okay. First, you need to fill this one first. You need to add this one. Then it will be easier. So, chess and carom, how many members play? 10 play chess and table tennis. Okay, 10 play chess and table tennis. So, chess and table tennis, 10 play. Okay. So, that is 4. This portion is 4. Those who play only chess and table tennis is 4. Okay. This portion is chess and table tennis. This is 10, right? So, 6 is already there. So, 10 minus 6 is 4. Okay. Eight play carom and table tennis. Eight play carom and table tennis. Okay. Carom and table tennis is this. Already 6 is there. So 8 minus 6 is 2. Okay. So this portion is carom and table tennis. So 8. Okay. And what else? 6 play, 10 play chess and table tennis, okay. 8 play carom and table tennis, 6 play all the 3 games, okay. Fair enough. Now, table tennis, how many members will play? 15 play table tennis. So, 15 minus 13, 6 plus 4 plus 2 is 12. So, 15 minus 12 is 3. Where is it? Yeah. So 3 here. Now add them up. N of t must be 15. 4 plus 6, 10 plus 2 plus 3, 15. Is there anything else we can find from the given data? Yes. We need to assume something. This portion we don't know. X. That is X, okay. So this C, okay, is nothing but this part is nothing but chess. How many members play chess? 22. 22 minus 10, 12. 12 minus X is this. Those who play only chess, okay. Those who play only caroms. 21 play carom. 21 minus 8 is how much? 21 minus 8. 20 minus 8 is 12. 21 minus 8 is 13. Okay. So this is 13 minus X. Is that fair enough? You can add them up. You must get the required number. Yes, 13 plus 2, 15. 15 plus 6, 21. Fair enough. Now, what you know is 35 is the total number. Okay. You have to add every individual number here. That must get 35. Okay. What is the sum here? 3, 10, 2, 5. 10 plus 2 plus 5, 15. Okay, 15 plus 13 plus 12. 13 plus 12 is 25. 25 plus 15 is 40. 40 minus X is 35. So X is 5. Okay. 45 minus X is that much means X is 5, right? So X. Since we already committed it here with X, we'll keep it here with X only, no problem. Okay, now what we need chess and carom but not table tennis. Chess and carom but not table tennis is X, that is X equal to 5. So this is the answer for first one. Second one, only chess, 12 minus X. 12 minus x is 12 minus 5, right? So I'll write it here, only just is 12 minus x, 12 minus x, okay? So 12 minus 5 is how much? 7. This number is 7. Only carom 13 minus x. Thirteen minus five is 8. One more. Yes. From chess. Okay. That's it. Not a difficult problem at all. In a class of 50 students, each one come to school by bus or by bicycle or on foot. 25 by bus, 20 by bicycle, 30 on foot, 10 students by all the three. How many students come to school exactly by two modes of transport? Two modes of transport means, see, these things are maybe transport systems. If you think them as transport systems, only two means x plus 2 plus 4 in this case. Okay, in the previous case, only two means this portion plus this portion. Okay, that's it. Everything is almost same. Okay, you need to follow the same procedure, but the final answer will be this. Okay, this plus this plus this plus this. Okay, you can do it on your own, I guess. See how beautiful this nature is. You also start planting the trees. Let us bring a new change in our society. Let us plant the trees and let others plant the trees. Let's take this pledge seriously from now. Thank you.